that's why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right.
Morning, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. Here at Castle Lake. You can see the lake right there behind me. Very nice, very beautiful view. I'm gonna head up there, to Heart Lake, and gonna hike up there, go up to probably around up there, that peak right there. Take some pictures of Mount Shasta. That's right up the way over here. This is the first time I've been here since last year, and since June 2021, the Mount Shasta Trail Association rerouted the trail, because before you kind of just, if you know where to go, you just kind of walk and the trail kind of, there's this bunch of different trails, but now we have, I guess it's well marked by Karens and by ribbons. And they're gonna make it a lot better. So let's see what they did. All right. It's a beautiful morning. Not too cold. It's gonna be about 80 degrees, I think, out here today. So it should be a nice morning for a hike. See, it begins out marking the trail. So right at the trailhead coming up. So Mount Shasta Trail Association have put up these signs just to keep you on the trail and not go on the old trail. So you can let the growth continue to grow and not step on it. So stay on the trail. Still on the trail. It's pretty well marked, but there are little trails that go off here and there that before people would just take, because not really knowing where to go, just in what direction. But I think up here is where we're really gonna start seeing the Karens and more ribbons. Like I said, trail really wasn't marked well before, and you would just kind of make your own way or follow whatever way other people went.
crossroads, because it looks like a trail's right there. It looks like a trail's right there. So I did a little looking around, see which way. And let me tell you folks, this is the proper use of cairns. Okay, these rock stacks, this is the proper use for them, so we can know where the hell the trail's at. Not because you want to be cool and take a picture stacking up stupid rocks. Yeah, it does hurt the environment or the habitat of wildlife and such, but not so much as leave no trace. You know what I mean? I don't want to have a stupid pile of rocks there to let me know that you were there. All right, I wanted to know so that it's marking the trail. Okay, leave no trace means leave no trace. Don't leave no graffiti. Don't be marking trees. Don't be leaving your trash. And don't be stacking stupid rocks. All right? Now that is the proper use for those rocks. Those cairns. It's just so nice out here. And another keynote to remember is that looks like a trail right there. However, there's a tree branches right here. Now, there's no fallen tree right here. These were moved here and put here so you can stay on the trail to let you know that area is blocked. Don't go that way. All right, we want the growth to continue to grow, and if we keep stepping on it, it's not gonna happen. So it's just to mark the way that this way is the way to go. Keep going straight. Even though that looks like a trail, doesn't mean you should take it. Mount Shasta Trail Association did a really good job at marking this trail for people. Because again, like the first time I came out here, thank God I had AllTrails, because I didn't know where the heck I was going at all. So I just followed the trail on my map. So now it's pretty well marked and maintained, so, and it's gonna be even better to where they're gonna be putting up signs so they don't have to have the ribbons and the little stakes telling you where to go and where not to go. Almost to the top. Look at that. Gosh. So beautiful. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Coming up to Heart Lake. Last time I was here was, I think last November, January maybe. And the lake was frozen. Now it's, it couldn't have been November. Probably January. Or December, I don't know, I'll have to look. But here you go, it's a little, stinking drought this year. Water levels are really low. And this is more of a pond than it is a actual lake. But it's still beautiful up here. So there's Heart Lake. One of the best views from Heart Lake is right here. You can see Castle Lake. See the majestic Mount Shasta.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your trails straight. Who said church has to be in a building?
Yes, I understand that every life must be.
So as you can see, I'm way up above. There's Heart Lake. I came all the trail up. Went all the way up there. Take some pictures. Now I made it all the way up here.
Some folks just have one, yeah, others
think I'm up there. And just follow the ridge down, and the trail connects. So I can go back down to the car. First time I've done this, and I'm going to try to see if there's a spot up here that I can come at a later time and set up camp. And I can get some gorgeous views of the sunset and sunrise. That's my goal. I've been here a few times and never made it up this far, and decided to come and explore a little more. There is a trail that I'm following, so it's pretty good. But man, this view is just amazingly gorgeous. Well, came up to the ridge, and look at that. That is a sight. Castle Crags. Beautiful. Never seen this side of it. Look at that view. Wonder every day as I look upon your face.
Everything you gave and nothing you would take. Nothing you would take. Everything you gave. Did I say that I need you?
I must say, if you're gonna come to Heart Lake, you definitely need to take that path up there, all the way up on the ridge, just to get that view of crags. Man, that is just beautiful. So I highly recommend that, doing that loop. I'll put my AllTrails link of my route in the description of the video. But yeah, man, it's just nice, so nice. Castle Crags. Yeah, and then just a higher elevation view of Heart Lake and Castle Lake and Mount Shasta. Just beautiful. There are some spots up here where it seems like it's been laid out where you can set up a tent, so I think I will be coming out here this fall before the snow comes and it gets too cold, just so I can catch that sunset and sunrise, baby. Yeah. All right, so if you are going to take that loop, I strongly advise to have AllTrails. There is reception up here. Well, with AT&T there is. But if you have if you have the subscription that you pay, you won't you can use it offline. So, but there is, we've gone on a few different little game trails, it seems like. So I'm just trying to stick to the map and not get too far off trail. I want to stay on this as much as possible because I want to see where it connects to the original trail. Kind of goes out and back in, but we're going to see. So, if you're going to go up on that ridge, I did the loop, but coming down, that it seems like it's just a bunch of game trail. It's actually called Middle Peak Bushwhack Trail. And I'm assuming it's called bushwhack because you got to bushwhack your way through on a lot of the parts. So, if you want to get the good view, I'd say just go up on the ridge and come around and then just make your way back. Make your way back down instead of doing the whole loop. It's not hard, but you can't get off trail and then just have to start bushwhacking your way through Manzanita.
I met Bill on the way down. He was one of the volunteers that helped the Mount Shasta Trail Association set up the ribbons and such to mark the trails. He's also into botany and just getting into geology. He was letting me know a little bit about it.
Not every plant has them.
And that's the huckleberry oak.
It's called huckleberry oak, yeah. And it's what they call a quercus. That's the genus of oak trees. And this is in that genus of oak trees, and it's an oak. It's just, you wouldn't know. You think it's just manzanita or ceanothus.
Yeah, and I actually, just walking past it, I think it was manzanita, but yeah, right, but yeah, now that you look at the...
Yeah, it may take you some time. When you're up here again, look for the little acorns or the little, you know how an acorn has a little top to
right.
it? They're in here, but they're just really, you know, I don't always find them if I look. Okay, that rock there that's kind of like checkerboard,
uh-huh.
That's a gabbro.
Gabbro, there you go. All right.
Named for a town in Italy.
Well, Bill, it's nice meeting you. All right, everybody. That's it for today. That's at the end of the trail. Thanks for watching. Thanks for visiting the channel. If you like the video, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Let us know you're watching. Let us know you care. And if you really like what you saw, then go ahead and click that subscribe button and that little bell notification. So every time we post a video, you'll be the first to watch. Again, thanks for watching and stay tuned for next time. Remember, adventure is out there.